More than 2,000 years, humankind has been using metal coins as money. Copper has been used as a metal for coins for a long period because it is a metal that is strong enough and less affected by external influences. At the same time, it is plastic enough that makes it easy to make coins out of it. Today, with the help of Mel Sion's electroplating set, we will make copper coins by ourselves. For this experiment, take a small petri dish and flatten a Play-Doh on it. To make the Play-Doh conduct electricity, cover with a layer of graphite, which is a material inside a pencil. Make a coin imprint by pressing the coin in the Play-Doh. The most important thing is to cover the coin imprint with graphite thoroughly. For a better contact and electroconductivity of the layer, cover the imprint with graphite. In the petri dish, pour in a whole bottle of copper sulfate and sodium hydrogen sulfate solution, which are the electrolyte. Then the solution will be able to conduct electricity and transfer copper ions. When there are hydrogen ions among other ions, the solution is acidic. Copper oxide, which bothers the copper plate to participate in the reaction and give copper ions, is removed from its surface under such acidic conditions. To start the electrochemical reaction, put a rubber stopper on the plate and turn on the electric current. Now we need to wait for 12 hours. The copper from the plate will transfer onto the graphite layer, forming a copy of a coin. So how does this happen? Under an electric current, the excess of electrons concentrates on the graphite, which can conduct electricity. The excess electrons move to the copper ions, changing them into atoms, which gradually cover the graphite. When there is an excess of electrons somewhere, there must be a shortage of electrons somewhere else in the electric chain. The part with electron shortage will be the copper plate in this experiment. Therefore, a reverse reaction happens on the copper plate. Copper atoms lose 2 electrons, turning into copper ions and get into the solution. Therefore, lots of copper layer grows on it, making the coin stronger. 12 hours later, pour the solution out from the petri dish, wash the coin with water, and take out the Play-Doh. The coin looks almost like a real coin. To make it even more realistic, cut off the excess copper. If you want to learn more about this experiment, please visit our Mel Science website.